Grouping symbols, level 2. All right, like always, let's jump straight into some examples. Simplify the following expressions. So here, what we want to do first is follow the rules of simplifying expressions without grouping symbols. In this case, we first need to take care of multiplication or division operators. And then after that, we need to take care of any subtraction and addition operators. So scanning the equation from left to right, there's an addition operator, so we skip it for now. And right next to it, there's a multiplication operator. So according to our rules, we take care of that first. So we simplify the expression 4 times 2, which simplifies to 8, and then we add 8 to that, which reduces to 16. Alright, let's try the next one. Here, we have a parentheses. We need to simplify the expression within the grouping symbol. First add 8 and 2, which simplifies to 10, and then here we will multiply 10 by 4, which gives us the final answer of 40. Alright, let's try the next one. So here, once again, we don't have any grouping symbols. So we first need to take care of any multiplication or division operators first. Scanning the equation from left to right, we first spot a division operator, so we take care of that first. So 10 divided by 5 is equal to 2, and then we add 5 to that. Let's try the next one. So here, it looks like that this expression is similar to the last one, but the only difference is that we have a grouping symbol from the start. So like always, we simplify the expression within the grouping symbol first. So adding 10 and 5 gives us 15, and now we take 15 and divide it by 5, which reduces to 3. Alright, let's try the next one. So this expression involves a fraction bar. So the first thing we need to do is simplify the numerator, and then simplify the denominator, and in the end, divide the simplified numerator over the simplified denominator. Let's work with the numerator first. So here, we first need to take care of the product 5 times 3, which reduces to 15, and then we add 9 to that, which is equal to 24. In the denominator, we add 7 and 1, which simplifies to 8. And now we take 24 and divide it by 8, which reduces to 3. Alright, let's try the next one. Once again, we have a fraction bar, so we take care of the numerator and the denominator first. Within the numerator, we first subtract 12 and 8, which reduces to 4, and then multiply that by 3, which reduces to 12. In the denominator, we first need to take care of the product, 5 times 2, which is equal to 10, and then subtract 4 to that, which reduces to 6. And lastly, we take 12 and divide it by 6, which is equal to 2. Alright, so now let's practice evaluating expressions. Evaluate the following expressions if t is equal to 6, x is equal to 3, y is equal to 4, and z is equal to 5. The way you want to approach these problems is by replacing or substituting each variable with the corresponding value of the variable, typically with a parentheses. Make sure you use the parentheses when substituting values. This will be very important in your future studies of algebra. So I'll simplify the expression 2x plus 7. So like always, we want to substitute the variable with the corresponding value. In this case, x is equal to 3. So we use parentheses to substitute x with 3. And now we simplify the expression. We first take care of the product, 3 times 2, which reduces to 6, and then we add 7 to that, which reduces to 13. Alright, let's try the next one. The quantity 18 minus 4 times t. So we first simplify the expression within the parentheses, and that reduces to 14. And now we have the expression 14 times t. In this problem, t is equal to 6. So we substitute t using parentheses with 6. And now we have 6 times 14, which simplifies to 84. Alright, let's try the next one. The expression 4 times x times z, or 4xz, plus 3 times y, or 3y. So we first need to substitute each variable with its appropriate value. X is equal to 3, z is equal to 5, and y is equal to 4. So now we simplify any products or divisions first. We simplify the expression 5 times 3 times 4 first, which simplifies to 60. And then we simplify the expression 4 times 3, which simplifies to 12. And finally, we add these two quantities, which simplifies to 72. The quantity y times y plus z times z. Once again, we have pure variables, so we have a purely variable expression. We substitute each variable with its appropriate value. Y is equal to 4, and z is equal to 5. So now we need to pay close attention to the grouping symbols, in this case, the bracket. We first need to take care of the expression within the bracket. Focusing on the expression within the bracket, we see that we first need to take care of the product, 4 times 4, which reduces to 16. And now we add 5 to that, which reduces to 21. And finally, we take 21 and multiply it by 5, which signifies to 105. All right, try the following one. The expression 2 times the quantity y plus x over the quantity 2y plus x. Once again, we need to substitute each variable using parentheses with the appropriate value. Y is equal to 4 and x is equal to 3. So now here we have a grouping symbol, specifically a fraction bar. We first need to take care of the expression within the parentheses in the numerator. We first add the numbers 4 and 3, which signifies to 7, and then multiply that by 2, which is equal to 14. Next, we take care of the denominator. We first need to multiply 4 and 2, which reduces to 8, and then add 3 to that, which reduces to 11. And finally, the final expression is 14 over 11. For the most part, leave your answer as an improper fraction. There's really no need to signify it as a decimal. But if you like, 14 over 11 is approximately equal to 1.27 after rounding to the nearest hundred. There's no need to write the answer as a decimal. So how about the following expression? 3 times the quantity z plus 5 times the quantity 2y minus x. So this is a perfect example of an expression that contains nested grouping symbols. Notice that we have the brackets, and within the brackets we have an expression with parentheses. We work from the innermost grouping symbol to the outermost grouping symbol. So in this case, we first need to take care of the expression 2y minus x. We first substitute each expression, and as always, with parentheses, z is equal to 5, y is equal to 4, and x is equal to 3. So now we need to take care of the quantity within the parentheses first. We first multiply 4 times 2, which reduces to 8, and then subtract 3 from that, which signifies to 5. And now we signify the expression within the brackets. We first need to take care of the expression 5 times 5, which signifies to 25, and then add 5 to that, which reduces to 30. And then we take 30 and multiply that by 3, which signifies to 90. Let's try a different type of problem. Fill in the blank by using either an equal sign or a does not equal sign to make a true statement. In these type of problems, what you want to do first is signify the left-hand side of the expression and the right-hand side of the expression. So you first signify the expression on the left-hand side. In order to do that, we need to signify the numerator and the denominator. So we first add the quantity 23 and 19, which signifies to 42, and then signify the denominator, which signifies to 14, and then take 42 and divide it by 14, which signifies to 3. Now the right-hand side contains no grouping symbols, so we need to follow the rules to signify expression without grouping symbols. We first need to divide 54 and 9, which signifies to 6, and then subtract 3 from that, which signifies to 3. So now that we have the left-hand side and the right-hand side signified, in order to make this a true statement, we need to substitute the blank with an equal sign. Let's try the next one. Once again, we need to signify the left-hand side. We have, once again, nested grouping symbols. So we need to work the innermost grouping symbol, in this case, the parentheses. So first we add 6 and 3, which signifies to 9. We work with the quantity within the brackets. So we take 36 and divide it by 9, which signifies to 4. And finally, we take 4 and multiply it by 3, which signifies to 12. The right-hand side also contains nested grouping symbols. We work with the innermost grouping symbol first. So we take 36 and divide it by 3, which signifies to 12. And then we add 6 to that, which signifies to 18. And finally, we take 20 and subtract 18, which signifies to 2. So now we have 12 on one side and 2 on the other side. The only way we can make this a true statement is by substituting the blank with a does not equal symbol. The whole purpose of this problem is to get a true statement. Let's try a distinct type of problem. Insert grouping symbols in the numerical expression so that its value is equal to A, 7, B, 17, and C, 25. Let's try A first. So in order to make this numerical expression equal to 7, the only way we could get that is by grouping the quantity 5 times 3 plus 6. So by grouping the expression 5 times 3 plus 6, we would have to work with the product first, which signifies to 15, and then add 6 to that, which is equal to 21. And finally, we take 21 and divide it by 3, which signifies to 7. All right, so let's try B. In order to obtain 17 from this expression, notice that we don't actually have to write any grouping symbols. We could just follow the rules of signifying numerical expression without any grouping symbols. So in order to signify this expression using the rules, we first need to take care of any multiplication or division operators. In this case, we first take care of 5 times 3, which signifies to 15, and then we take care of 6 divided by 3, which signifies to 2. So 15 plus 2 gives us 17. In this particular example, there was no need to insert any grouping symbols to give us a value of 17. All right, so let's try the last one. How can we group the numerical expression so that it gives us a final answer of 25? The only way that we could get 25 is by grouping the expressions 3 plus 6 divided by 3. Doing so, we would have to take care of the division sign first within the parentheses. So we take 6 divided by 3, which is equal to 2, and then we add 3 to that, which is equal to 5. And finally, 5 times 5 is equal to 25. If you still don't feel confident, I suggest you practice some more before you continue. In our next video, we will go over the basic structures of equations.